I'm going to read from my first book, Floodmarkers, and this is from a chapter that is a short story also called Floodmarkers that is about a character, Fletcher, a teenage girl who is suffering from cancer, and she's just found her best friend and neighbor in the floodwaters in the park outside their house and saves her neighbor. And so the neighbor that she's saved has just been brought inside, and now Fletcher is looking out at the floodwater from her front door. From the front door, she watched the water gently wash through the grass in her yard, a daily view rendered suddenly exotic. The curve of the flower bed was now the bank of a pond. In the middle of the yard, the oak tree that she'd almost never noticed before now seemed austere and grand, rising out of the water. A bright red shirt floated by, a brush stroke through the space that had so recently been only a front yard. The neighborhood. There was an alternate view to it all, something other than night and day. It made Fletcher feel alive, in tune with her senses. She wasn't dying. She was a lifesaver. She was a swimmer. She opened the storm door and walked into the water. The shock of the chill dulled with her legs still wet. She crossed the street, the water reaching up to her calves now, and then into the park until the water touched her waist. Then she dove. Underwater, she opened her eyes. The geography of the park was barely visible as she stroked into the water. But soon Moe's Rock appeared below her, the footpath stretching away into the murky depths. She dropped deeper and floated just above the footpath, like a ghost visiting the landmarks of her life, then drifted over the grass and past a small bed of ferns swaying in the water. She felt endangered and rash, flush with the risk of life. She rolled over, and the surface of the floodwater appeared gray in the stormlight above, shifting and shattered and low. She was in complete control, circling her hands to keep herself in position. Small branches and bits of vegetation floated gently by, yet there was barely any current, just a random spilling of the banks. Soon her lungs began to burn, and she reluctantly started to rise. The hour of medication and pillows neared as she floated upwards, and when her nose surfaced at the same time as her toes, rain pounded her emerging flesh like a thousand tapping fingers, insisting she awaken.